Hello kids, hope you all are good. Yes, even I am also good children. Thank you. Today I am going to tell you a story for you. Are you ready to listen to me? Yes, here we go. See children, a dog is standing near step 1. It wants to reach to step 10. So it started climbing from step 1. It went to step 2. Then it goes to step 3. Then it went to step 4. It went to step 5. It went to step 6. It went to step 7, then 8, then 9, finally it reached to step 10 to take the bone. See children, here the dog started from step 1. From step 1 to step 10 it went. That means it started in smaller number and went to bigger number. So arranging numbers from smaller number to bigger number is called ascending order or increasing order. That means arranging numbers from small to big. After it reached to the 10th step, the dog wants to come down. So from 10th step to, it came to 9th step, it came to 8th step, it came to 7th step, it came to 6th, it came to 5th, it came to 4th, it came to 3rd, it came to 2nd, and finally it reached to step 1. So the dog came from bigger number to smaller number. So arranging numbers from bigger number to smaller number is called descending or decreasing order. That means big to small. Children, do you all know ant? How ant will be? It is a tiny creature, yes? Yes, it is very small. Remember one thing, children. Ascending order means ant. Ant is very small, no? Ant. So, small to big. When you are doing sums related to ascending order, you should remember ant. Ascending order means ant. So, ant is small. So, I have to arrange numbers from small to big. Do you all know dinosaur? How dinosaur will be, children? Yeah, very big. So, dinosaur means descending order. That means dinosaur is big to small. So ascending order means ant, small to big. Descending order means dinosaur, big to small. Now hope you all understood what I am going to teach you today. Yes, today I am going to teach you ascending and descending order. It is also known as increasing order or decreasing order. Ascending and descending order. Let me take some examples to teach you. Like 238. Let me write bigger. 238, 283, 382, 328, 832 are the 5 numbers, and all these 5 numbers are 3 digit numbers. Now I just want to arrange these 5 numbers in ascending order. So I already told you that ascending order means ant, small to big. So if I want to compare any number, I should start comparing with hundreds place, yes or no? So let us start comparing with their hundreds places. Like here in this hundreds place is 2. In this number also hundreds place is 2. Here is also, here is 3. And here is 3. Here is 8. So ascending order means small to big. Which is the smallest number here? 2, 3, 8. Yes, it is 2. But I have 2 numbers are having 2 hundreds place. The 2 numbers are having same hundreds place. What shall I do? Then I should go and check with their tens place. Here the tens place is 3 and here the tens place is 8. I am writing ascending order, that means small to big. So I have to check with smaller number. Either 3 is bigger or 8 is bigger. 8 is bigger, but I want smaller. So 238 is smaller than 283. After 200 I have 300. But there also I have two numbers which are having same place value. So I should go and check with their tens place. Here in this number I have 8, in this number I have 2, which is a smaller number. It's 2. So 328 is bigger than, is next number is 382, and finally we have 832. Let me take another example to explain you clearly. 940, 949, 942, 946. Arrange these numbers in descending order. So, descending order means I told you, remember dinosaur. Dinosaur is big. So, big to small, we should arrange. See here all, let us check this hundreds place. Here hundreds place is 9, in this number also 9. In this number also I have 9 as hundreds place. This number also hundreds place is 9. So I told you when we have hundreds place are same in all the numbers, we should go to tens place. Let us check now tens place in these numbers. So here I have tens place is 4. Here also I have 4. In this number also I have 4. In this also I have 4. See, all these four numbers are having same tens place. So hundreds place is same, tens place is same. Let us go and check to ones place. Here ones place is 0, and in this number I have ones place as 9. In this number I have ones place as 2, and in this number I have ones place as 6. I am going to arrange in descending order. That means big to small. Let me find which is the biggest number. Biggest one digit number, like sorry, ones place number is 0926. Which is the biggest number? Yes, it is 9, 949. Then after 9, we have 6 here, 946. 6 after bigger one, either 0 or 2. 2. So 942. Last, I have 940. Yes or no, children? Yes. I am going to arrange this same set of numbers into ascending order also. So I have to compare with their hundreds place. Already we know that all hundreds places are equal. I don't know how to arrange ascending order also. Then I have to check with tens place. Here all the tens places are also same. Then I have to go with ones place. Ascending order means small. I have to check with a small number. Which is the smallest number in ones place? 0, 9, 2, 6. Tell me which is the smallest number. Either 0, 9, 2 or 6. So it is 0. We all know that 0 is the smallest number. So next after 0 we have 9, 2, 6. In this 3 which is the smallest? Ones place value 2, 942. After 2 what we have? 946 is the biggest number. Then at last 949 is the biggest number. Now let me take one more example. Like you know, here in all these sums I gave, like all the numbers are 3 digits. Suppose if you get in one sum 2 digits, then how will you find or how will you order them? So let me say, let me tell you. 651, 165, 615 and 65. See children, here I am going to arrange this number in ascending order. That means small to big. See, this number is having 3 digits. This number is having 3 digits. And this number is also having 3 digits. But this number is having only 2 digits. That means 1s and 10s. I didn't get your hundreds place. If I didn't have any hundreds place over there, I can write 0 over there. That means 0 doesn't have value at starting, at first. So I can keep 0 there. So let us compare these numbers first. So compare numbers first with hundreds place. In this number I have 6. In this number I have 1. In this number also I have 6. In this number I have 0. Ascending order, small one. I have to pick the small one. Which number is having the smallest place value, hundreds place value? That means here 6, 1, 6, 0. Yes, 0 is the smallest place value there. So 65 is the smallest number. If I write 0 or not at first, doesn't have any value. So leave it. Then after 65, 0 after 1 I have. So I have to write 165. Later on, I have 1 after 2 6 hundreds place I have. So what to do? I told you already, when hundreds places are same in any two numbers, we should go with tens place. Let us check their tens place. In this number, tens place is 5. In this number, tens place is 1. Now tell me, which is the smallest? 5 or 1? Because we are writing ascending order means add small to big. 5 is small or 1 is smaller? 1 is smaller. So I have to write 615 and plus 651. Is it so, children? Did you all understood? Okay. Let me tell you another example regarding one ascending order and one descending order, so that you will not get any doubt about this. Like example 1 is 146, 283, 159 and 249. Arrange these numbers in ascending order. Ascending order means small to big. First we have to check with their hundreds place. Hundreds place, here in this number I have 1, in this number I have 2, in this number I have 1, and again in this number I have 2. Let me tell you. See, which is the smallest number? I have 2 ones here, 2 twos here. How can I find? In this 4, I can say that 1 is the smallest number, but I have 2 numbers over there, so I have to go and check with their tens place also. So after 1, I have tens place value here, that is 4 in 100 tens place and 5 in tens place. So which is the smallest? It's obviously 146 is the smallest. Later on, 159 is bigger. That we have 200s over there. Let me check which is the smallest number in those two. See, here in this number tens place is 8, in this number tens place is 4. Which is the smallest? 8 or 4? Yes, 4. 8 or 4. 200, next 283. So children, let me take another example. Like 230, 302 and 32. These are the three numbers we should arrange in descending order. Descending order means big to small. See, all these two numbers are having three digit number, but this is only two digit number, so that in hundreds place I can keep 0. Now find out the hundreds place in all these three numbers. In this number, hundreds place is 2. In this number, hundreds place is 3. In this number, hundreds place is 0. Which is the biggest hundreds place value? It is 2 or 3 or 0. Yes, 3. So, 302. Later on, bigger number is 230. Then we have 32. So, I arranged these three numbers in descending order. So, once again, I am repeating. Ascending order means you have to remember ants, small to big. Descending order means this dinosaur, you have to remember big to small. I want everyone to open page 94, exercise 2.6. In that you have sums regarding decreasing order and increasing order in 94 and 95 page. I want you all to do those assignment, like do in your textbook. And understand well. Hope you all understand well. Take care of yourselves. Stay home. Bye bye.